Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play City of Crime Gang Wars on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install City of Crime Gang Wars and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play City of Crime Gang Wars. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, to start we have to launch our favorite internet browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to that URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type anything, because there's a clickable link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We arrived at this point on the website of Usitility, at which we have a meticulous explanation on the best way to download and install City of Crime Gang Wars on PC. We browse lower a little bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on that link, we get to the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will use to play City of Crime Gang Wars on the PC. As you can discover here, we access some pros of running that emulator. Then, we are on the way to start downloading the City of Crime Gang Wars by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green color. We then click on the button. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It's a file we have to execute. What we have to do now is to run the installer, okay, then we need to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We have clicked yes. I reduce the web browser to find the installer better. The installation software is quite simple. It contains two possibilities, install and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path really does. We simply click on it. And then we realize that we end up with here the path where the emulator can be installed. If we are planning to change this folder, we have got to click on the browse option, and now we opt for another directory and set up the emulator where we prefer. To keep it simple, just leave it by default. I click on back. And therefore I just click on install. Great. The install begins and it's going to go forward with the download of all these megabytes that happens to be shown on the computer screen. After you download it, it could be more or less megabytes. The download rate can be faster or slower, depending on your web access and according to the performance of the emulator servers. Now they are working extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5, you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator has actually been started immediately. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar that will move forward to the right and when it has reached the end, the emulator is started for the first time. The reality is the emulator has been started, here for the very first time. Before we continue on, as now you can see, it has made two app icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be only one we are concerned about. When we would like to operate City of Crime Gang Wars on the PC, we twice mouse click on this icon and launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me conduct the following step, that is a must-have, and that is to visit the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is presented. Right here we must log on. Right now once we're there, we must absolutely do this next step that is definitely imperative. So we mouse click on, sign in. At present it announces, checking info. It could in some cases get stopped at, checking info, and it fails to move ahead. In that case, you may attempt to log in after a number of hours and it will usually be repaired. At present we can insert our email and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email as well as its matching password. For example, you make use of the exact same email you use at this moment in your YouTube account. So that I will enter my data and I will come back immediately after I have completed it. That's all, info typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and presenting us the twos. We will consent to them all by clicking, I agree. Then, it allows us to save to the Google Cloud. You could keep it checked and this will produce a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We click accept. The Google Play Store is started automatically and immediately. To set up the game, we would need to go to the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking on this app icon marked green colored. Currently that we are discovering the desktop of this Android emulator, we can see that we have there the install video game option. We then click on the button. At this point we come with the game app. Let's quickly then click here on the install choice that I'm presenting now in green color. This will launch the software installation. At present it is going to download and install the game. It can take quite some time or it could also be extremely fast. It again all relies on our own internet connection. This has by then finished installing. Back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this particular button I'm highlighting in green, if you want to launch City of Crime Gang Wars for the very first time. I am currently on the emulator desktop, then we're on the way to click on the new City of Crime Gang Wars software icon that was created. That game app is started for the first time. Here we have it, I am able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the volume level of this emulator. This is here, we use the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. As well as to appreciate the experience to the maximum, we could activate the big screen, for which we have two options. That is simply the first one, we just click on that icon which I am actually showing in green color. Then the display screen is maximized, offering one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In the case that we choose to have fun with the video game using all the screen, we hit that app icon. And we might at present be experiencing the gameplay in full screen function. To leave the complete screen functionality, push the F11 key. So we would definitely now end up being in standard screen setting. From now, I am on the way to demonstrate to you the computer keyboard mapping and that is surprisingly appealing. That strategy we will certainly be ready to utilize the game application much more effortlessly. The first task is to press this keyboard icon. And right now there you will have the ability to get the required setups. I am going to let the default settings, though if you like to improve it, you may very well achieve it without having problem. As you can notice, the emulator is fully in our own language. In some cases it occurs that the emulator is presented in the wrong language, such as, in Japanese. And as a result to set it up in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. So right here inside of additional configuration settings, we click on the language drop down. We are able to decide on the language we wish, Italian, Chinese, and so forth. When the language is determined, we should save, the emulator will restart, and also the game application, the next time we launch it, would also be in the specified language. At this time, you can find another information that we will need to take into consideration, and it is that we will get an email reporting that a completely new device has been connected with our Google account. It will likely question us if we're the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Yes, we should not worry, since the emulator is behaving like an Android device. And in order to determine which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. Be sure to browse here to the model choice. And right here we learn that the emulator is emulating a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for that training. I hope that you liked it, especially that you thought it was informative. If that's the case, bring it a great thumb up, subscribe to our channel, and I will be happy to answer all your comments, issues or ideas, leave them in the comment box below. You may also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams from time to time, you have it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of these instructional videos that happens to be showing up on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the following video tutorials. Bye.